करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः गोब्रह्माणविदधाति पूर्वं येदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मोक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमः सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं पारं सर्वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेव अन्नमत्वं मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो कंटिन्यू विद द पंचकोश विवेक मन आत्मवाद अन्य आहुः प्राणः जडः। So earlier it was said that the Hiranyagarbha Upasaka consider the Samashti Prana, Hiranyagarbha, as Atma. So Prana is Jada Sedi Mana Atma Vadis. So Jada cannot be Chetana Atma, Tasmat Sana Atma, Ghata Adivatya. Like Ghata Pata Ityadi, Jada cannot be Atma. Bandha Moksha Manu Matra Adhinu. Bandha and moksha are dependent on mana. Manas itself makes or breaks a person. Thereby for a sadhaka also, mind is important. For a laukika also, the mind is important. So what is atma? It is mind alone, nothing else. Because even the Upanishad says, mana eva manushyanam karanam bandha moksha yoga. So mind is a karana for bandha and moksha. So, taking cue from that, this Mana Atmavadi says that Mana is Atma, Manas is Atma. Vishayak Saktam Manaha Bandha Hetuhu. The Manas which is attracted towards the Vishaya becomes a Bandha Karana. Whereas, Vishaya Vasana Shunya Manaha Moksha Hetuhu. Whereas, without the Vasana for Vishayas, when it is withdrawn, it becomes the Moksha Hetu. So without the mind manifest, there is nothing else. So Atma is nothing but Mana. Kincha Manas Sambandhadeva Indriyanam Swasva Vishayava Bodhana Samarthyam. And earlier we saw that when the Indriyas are not backed by the Manas, that time Indriyas do not function, meaning they do not register whatever Vishayas they come in contact with. The person does not register. They do not register the Vishayas for the person to cognize because the Manas is not backing. Na anyatha. Without the mind backing, there cannot be any Indriya Samarthya to gather the information from Vishaya. Tasmat Manaha Eva Sarva Vyavahara Karanam. Ataha Mana Eva Atma. So the Manas is the Vyavahara Karana. For all vyavaharas, thereby Manas is Atma. Then this Mana-Atma-Vada is refuted in the Tippana. Narada Pancharatra Tantranusarinaha Manayeva Atma iti Vadanti. So he is saying, who are these who say it? Those who follow a particular part of Vedas, Pancharatra. So based on that, they say, so Tantra. Following that, there is Tantra. They say Manas is Atma. Tadapina Sambhavati. That too is not possible. Manas is not Atma. Manas is a Kosha. It's a Kosha. Why so? So Tankavasya Adivad Manasaha Karanatvat na Manaha Atma. Like the carpenter's tools, you know, like a hammer, axe, whatever the carpenter uses. Manas is an instrument. Like the carpenter's tools, it cannot be karanatvat manaha na atma. Karanatvat, that is karanatvat hetoho. Because it is a karana, whatever is a karana has to be separate from the subject. So subject object division was shown earlier in other cases. Here also subject object division will be there, but still karanatvam is seen. It's an instrument. Instrument cannot be the subject himself. Shushuptyadav manasaha abhave api samanya chaitanyasya sattvat sati manasi chaitanyam tadabhave tadabhava ityanvay vyatirekasya iti anvay vyatirekasya bhangat na manaschetanam kintu jadameva. How do you establish that the manas is not chetana and it is jada? So there he says shushuptyadu manasa abhavi api samanya chaitanyasya sattvat. Samanya chaitanya is there in shushupti, otherwise you wouldn't recall anything on waking up. You do recall that I slept well, there was ananda, and I did not know anything. That is possible only when you are chetana. Even during shushupti you are conscious. Although we say that, you know, I slept like a log, but still the real I is conscious. Alupta druk, always witnessing sakshi, where the mind does not exist. In shushupti avastham, the mind is resolved into the atma. Even then samanya chaitanya is there. And then what do you know? Sati manasi chaitanyam. So manasi sati, when the mind is there, chaitanyam tadabhave tadabhava iti anvaya vyatirekasya bhangat. So the anvaya and vyatireka shown by the manatmavadi is what? When the mind is there is chaitanya. When the mind isn't there is no chaitanya. Therefore mind is atma. That anvaya vyatireka is countered by showing that in shushupti the mind isn't there, not manifest at all, but still there is chaitanya. Therefore manaha chetanam na bhavati kintu jadam eva bhavati tasmat manaha na atma, and jada cannot be chetana atma. Mama manaha anyatra gatam idanim pratyagatam iti vyavaharat manaha mamatayaha visheha na ahantaya. Again here the shakti sambandha is shown. Therefore the subject object division, the owned and the owner, they are separate. So mama manaha anyatra gatam, it has gone elsewhere, my mind has gone elsewhere. So my mind, therefore there is a sambandha there. Idanim pratyagatam, now it has come back. So you know that it is objectifiable by you, therefore it is not atma. Tasmat manasa stairyas chanchalyadi vetta sakshi bhutatma mano vilakshana siddha. So sakshi subject object division is shown here. Chetana bhasa sahitamyo manaha bhoktru bhavati na swatantram manaha ataha abhoktrutvadapi manaha na atma. Chaitanya abhasa sahitamyo manaha, that antakkarana mind which plays the role of the mind becomes a bhokta only when it is along with the chaitanya bhasa chidabhasa. Without the chaitanya and chidabhasa, the mind cannot by itself become bhokta. Therefore abhoktrutvat hetoho manaha na atma. And then the shruti is quoted here, manayo manushyanam karanam bandhamokshyo bandhaya vishyasaktam muktaye nirvishayam smritam. So mind itself is the karana for bandha and moksha. For bandha, it is drawn towards the vishaya, and for mukti, it should be withdrawn from the vishaya. Iti vachanasya ayam ashaya. This was the basis on which the manatmavadi was saying manas is atma. So this has to be countered, this has to be explained. Now you have misunderstood this. What this means is vishaya vasana vasitam manaha moksha sadhanam pratibadhya jagad adhyasaspadam bhutva jagad adhyasaspadam bhutva bandha karanam bhavati. So mind becomes the karana for bandha. How? Vishaya Vasana Vasitam Manaha. Becoming attracted towards the Vishaya because there is a Vasana left in the Antakkarana. Purva Karma Janita Vasana is there. And that mind, Moksha Sadhanam Pratibadhya. It creates obstacles to the Moksha and thereby Moksha and Moksha Sadhana. The Chitta Shuddhi is a sadhana for Jnanotpatti. Thereby Moksha. So Chitta Shuddhi is not possible when Vishaya Vasana Vasita Mana exists. When mind becomes Vishaya Vasana Vasita. Vasanas are there, but then these vasanas manifesting and ragadvesha and dragging the person along, that causes obstacles towards the moksha sadhana. Thereby, jagadadhyasaspadam bhutva. It becomes in the form of the adhyasa now. It projects. Since the atma remains veiled when the manaha is vishayavasana vasita, the avarna continues to be there and the vikshepa takes the person along with it, thereby bandhakaranam bhavati. Tadeva cha manaha vishayavasana rahitam jnana prapti dvara manasa swarupam bhaditva moksha karanam bhavati iti vachanasya ayam ashaya. So the vachanasya kaha ashaya, this is the idea there. The same mind, when it is withdrawn from the vishaya vasana, it is bereft of vishaya vasanas and thereby does not hanker after the vishayas, then what will happen is that it will be a sadhana for jnanotpatti because the chitta is shuddha. Therefore, jnana prapti dvara manasa swarupam bhaditva. Mind which is a monkey mind, keeps on jumping here and there, is no longer jumping. Thereby, it remains at composure and facilitates jnanotpatti, thereby moksha karanam bhavati. Natad vakyam manasa eva atmatam bodhayati. However, that mantra does not say that mind is atma. That is not the tatpare at all. Kintu bandha sadhanat nivruttim moksha sadhane pravruttim cha tad vakyam bodhayati. What it reveals is that the mind is the karana for bandha as well as moksha as a sadhana. It reveals the mind as a sadhana. Therefore, bandha sadhanat nivruttim. Since mind is the sadhana for moksha, if it gets dragged towards the vishayas, then it will no longer be a sadhana for moksha. Therefore, bandha sadhanat nivruttim moksha sadhane pravruttim cha tadvakyam bodhayati. Therefore, it says that mind which is under the control of the buddhi, that will withdraw itself from vishayas and therefore it will free the person from the obstacles. Bandha sadhanat nivruttim. And then it will become the sadhana for moksha. Therefore, pravritti towards moksha sadhana is possible only when the manas is not hankering after vishayas. Mano brahmeti vyajanat. So this Taittiriya mantra says that mano brahmeti vyajanat. De ityadina manomaya koshasya atmatva bodhaka shrutehe tatparyantu stularundhati nyayena iti prak pradarshitam. This stularundhati nyaya or shakachandra nyaya, easier to understand, is used by the Taittiriya Upanishad to withdraw the person from the outer kosha being considered as atma. Therefore, the inner kosha is shown as atma. Then once you go further inward, then the innermost pratyagatma becomes atma, known as atma, whereas the other atmas, misunderstood as atmas, get negated as koshas, not as atma. That is the tatparya which has been shown earlier. So that is the refutation of mana atma vada. So vijnanamaya kosha is atma, vijnanavadi bauddha matam, buddhi eva atma. So this is what the Bauddha Mata is also. Vijnana is misunderstood as consciousness itself. Buddhi is the manifestation or a role of the antakarana, and that itself appears as conscious. When it appears as conscious, the Buddhas misunderstand that itself as Atma, as Chetana Vastu, and then in them there is, you know, there is a bheda between their own, you know, subdivisions in their darshana, Buddha darshana. They consider either consciousness to be an abhasa, manifestation in the, of the antakarana itself appearing as a vishaya and then momentary, or they say that it isn't really there, appears to be there but it isn't there. They don't understand the concept of mithya, so they land on shunyatvam, either kshanika vijnana or shunyatvam. So that part begins here as vijnanavadi bauddhamatam. There are other vijnanavadis also, so we look at that. Kshanika vijnanavadi bauddha evam aha. So what do they say? Manasa vyaparaha buddhyadinaha bhavati. The mind cannot function without the buddhi being there. And buddhi there has to be understood as the vrityatmaka jnana. And it appears as chetana because the identification itself is at the level of the antakkarana, although it is at the avidya level, at the karana, sharira, still the first manifest identification is with the ahankara, which is the role of the same antakkarana, which appears as buddhi. And this ahankara also cannot be known unless there is some vichara, some jnanatmaka vritti. So when jnanatmaka vritti takes place, sorry, vrityatmaka jnana, either way you take it, it is a vritti in the antakkarana, which is basically the modification of the mind, a thought form. That's a vichara, which is the role of the buddhi, where the chetana is clearly manifest. The first level of clear manifestation of chetana. Thereby what happens is that they think that manasa vyapara, and thereby any vyapara is buddhyajina. It is dependent upon the buddhi. Yataha buddhi akareva manaha. What is the mind but it is the akara of the buddhi itself. It is nothing other than buddhi. Tasmat kshanika vijnana rupa buddhi hi eva atma bhavitum arhati. So what is that buddhi? Kshanika vijnana rupa. It is that manifest consciousness. This is what their thinking is. Momentary though, because as long as the thought exists, there is a conscious being that I think I am. So I think I am. When there is vichara, which the French philosopher also says, you know, I think, therefore I am. It isn't true. You are even without thinking, but still they miss that vision of the Shastras because there is no Shraddha in the Shastras. They have set aside, Buddhas have set aside the Vedas, therefore they can't land on the exactitude of the Shastras, which is the consciousness bereft of any thought, any vijnana, any layering, which cannot be kshanika at all. Everything else is kshanika, but this is nitya. Manaha na atma iti tesha vayam ashayaha. So what is their idea when they say mind is not atma, and vijnana is atma, buddhi is atma, sarve padartha vijnanasya eva akara bhavanti. So all of these are vrittis. Now if you take it as the vrittis of the mind, then mind itself will become atma, but then there is consciousness there. There is consciousness in the sense, manifest consciousness there. Therefore, that manifestation of consciousness which makes vichara possible, which makes you to distinguish one vishaya from the other, all of those padarthas from one another, they themselves are what? Nothing but vijnana's manifestation. Tachya vijnanam prakasha rupam. That is why you know the vishaya prakasha rupam. Pratikshanam vijnanam utpadya vinashyati. and you see it as momentary, because with each padartha you know that I am conscious of this vishaya, then another vishaya, then yet another vishaya. Whenever you cognize a vishaya, it is just the akara of vijnana which comes up and goes. So it's a momentary consciousness at each level of the vishaya, at each padartha level it is momentary consciousness. तथा एव तृतीय विज्ञान उत्पत्तो द्वितीय विज्ञानस्य विनाशः भवति, तुरीय विज्ञानस्य उत्पत्तो तृतीय विज्ञान नाशो भवति, एवं नदी प्रवाहवत् विज्ञानस्य धारा अवच्छिन्न अनुवर्तते. सो लाइक अ नदी प्रवाह आफ्टर वन वृत्ति अनदर वृत्ति, देयर इज अ कंटीन्यूअस फ्लो ऑफ वृत्ति लाइक अ फ्लो ऑफ रिवर. And it appears to be continuous because the padarthas are cognized every now and then. If it is not something that you are seeing, then it is something that you are hearing, something that you are smelling, touching, tasting. So all these vishayas are as though bombarding you every now and then. You, in a sense, you the philosopher, is misunderstanding this consciousness as being continuous, because it appears like a flow of river, but it is not the same water. In the example also, you cannot say the water is the same. The water keeps on changing. It is a continuous flow. It appears to be continuous, but it's a flow of different water. Every time you dip your hand in the water, it is not the same water that you have touched earlier. So prathama and dvitiya, there is a difference between the dip. If you dip your hand once and then the second time, it is not the same water that you are touching. It is a pravaha, appears to be same, but it isn't. This is their argument. Therefore, it's a continuous flow, right? Nadi pravaha vat vijnanasya dhara. Vijnana is also flowing, appears to be continuous, but it is one unit after the other. There is a kshanika vijnana, avachinna. It is always broken, it is not continuous. Anuvartate sacha vijnana dhara dvividha, and this flow is of two types. Now he says eka ale vijnana dhara anyatu pravritti vijnana dhara. So they segmented in their own language, they segment two parts to this pravaha. One is aham vritti, aham iti vijnana dhara, ale vijnana dhara iti kirtyate, saya buddhir iti kathyate. अयम घटः अयम देह इति विज्ञानधारा प्रवृत्ति विज्ञानधारा इति भण्यते, आले विज्ञानधारायाः सकाशात् प्रवृत्ति विज्ञानधारा उत्पद्यते. नाउ दिस इज समथिंग सिमिलर टू दी अहम वृत्ति एंड इदम वृत्ति दैट वेदांता टॉक्स अबाउट. सो दे टेक यू फ्रॉम दैट, बट देन दे से इवन इन दैट दिस अहम दैट विज्ञानधारा, आई एम even Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi talks about it. I am, there is a Spurana. So they agree with this Purana, Bauddhas. But they say that this Purana itself is appearing at the other. So ayam ghata, ayam deha, iti vijnana dhara, pravritti vijnana dhara, that alaya vijnana dhara yaha sakasha, from this alaya vijnana dhara, aham vritti, pravritti vijnana dhara, this ayam ghata, ayam deha, iti utpadyate, these continue to come up as idam vritti. So idam vritti is born out of aham vritti. Now I am explaining this idam vritti, aham vritti, because you don't want to use this alaya vijnana dhara and pravritti vijnana dhara. I am showing the similarity with what Vedanta says. However, alaya vijnana dharayaha sakashat प्रवृत्ति विज्ञान धारा उत्पद्यते मनस स्वरूपमपि प्रवृत्ति विज्ञान धारांतर्भूतमेव. दि मनस दि स्वरूप ऑफ दि अंतकरण विच इज व्हाट इज द रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ दि मन एव आत्मा. सो दे से दैट माइंड इज नॉट आत्मा बिकॉज व्हाट इज दि माइंड मनस स्वरूपमपि प्रवृत्ति विज्ञान धारांतर्भूतमेव. सो इट इज द स्वरूप ऑफ द माइंड इज आल्सो अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस अयम घटः अयम देहः सिमिलरली अयम मनः. which is born out of aham vritti. Alaya vijnanadhara. So it is not, the alaya vijnanadhara itself is not continuous. From which other objective thoughts are born. Similarly, the mind is also another object which is born out of it. Alaya vijnanadharaya pravritti vijnanadharayaha bada chintanena nirvishesha kshanika vijnanadharayaha sitihi siddhyati. So once you see that the mind is coming and going, alaya vijnanadharaya pravritti vijnanadharayaha bada chintanena. This is pravritti vijnanadhara, ayam ghataha, ayam deha. When ayam deha is known, this ayam ghata, this ghata vritti goes away, deha vritti comes up. Similarly, manas also. Now they say that bada chintanena. If you inquire into it as to what comes and goes, then nirvishesha kshanika vijnana dharayaha stitihi siddhyati. Then what do you know? You know that there is a dhara of ayam. Ayam ghataha, ayam pataha, ayam manas. Not ayam, idam manas. Neuter. So you inquire into it, the mind is also an object. And every padartha which comes to cognition is the manifestation of this ayam. Through ayam, idam vritti basically, in pullinga ayam, it is the manifestation of aham itself. And this aham now is a continuous dhara. Aham, aham, aham. So there is a spurana. However, it is not really continuous. It appears to be continuous like a flow of river. Therefore, what is established is that, he says, nirvishesha kshanika vijnana dharayaha stitihi siddhyati. There is no vishesha to this aham vritti. All this nirvishesha aham vritti is the real atma. And what is it? It is kshanika. Tadrishi sthitireva tanmate mokshaha. He says, it is this itself. No, being in that kshanika vritti itself is moksha. Itham vijnanavadinha buddhehe kshanikatam swayam prakash rupatancha kalpayitva. Kalpayitva. Why? Because there is no shruti basis. They've taken something from the shruti and parceled it differently. Sabuddhi eva atma iti varnayanti. They say this kshanika vijnana buddhi is itself atma. What is a khandana? The tippanakara says vijnana vadi mata khandanam is buddha shishyam yogacharam ye anusaranti te kshanika vijnana rupam buddhim atma iti varnayanti. So yogachara, there is one segment of Buddhism called yogachara. They say that vijnana is kshanika, consciousness is kshanika, that is atma. Tadasangatam, that is not right. Why? Rupadinam jnana rupam karyam prati netradindriyam sadhanam. Tatha nischaya rupa karyam prati sadhana bhuta buddhihi na atma bhavitum arhati. Why? Sadhanatvat, karanatvat na atma. It's a karana. Just like manas is karana, similarly buddhi is also karana. Just like indriyas are karanas for rupa ityadi, similarly nischaya rupakar, nischaya atmika buddhi hi, says tattva bodha also. So nischaya atmika buddhi, that which helps you to decide one way or the other, that is the buddhi. It is a sadhana, not atma itself. Sadhana and the subject who uses it as sadhana cannot be one. Kintu sarvapadartha nischayika. Kintu sarvapadartha nischayikayaha buddhehe yah sakshi sa eva atma. Sakshi cannot be the sadhana. Sadhana cannot be the sakshi. Therefore, atma is not sadhana. Atma uses the sadhana in the form of buddhi. Sa atma swayam, there is a typo here. Sa atma swayam prakash rupatva sada bhasate. Buddhi is not swayam prakasha. You know, it is the atma which makes buddhi appear to be having prakasha, appears sentient, but still atma is swayam prakasha natu buddhi. Ataha bhasya rupad अतः भाष्य रूपादेः भासकः सूर्यादि यथा भाष्य विलक्षण तथा भाष्य बुद्धेः भासकः आत्मा बुद्धेर विलक्षण सिद्ध्यति. वन हु इल्यूमिनेट्स द बुद्धि जस्ट लाइक द सूर्य इल्यूमिनेटिंग द प्रपंच इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम द प्रपंच. सिमिलरली द इल्यूमिनेटिंग आत्मा हु इल्यूमिनेट्स द बुद्धि हैज टू बी सेपरेट फ्रॉम द बुद्धि. यथा दीपादे प्रकाशो घटादिना संबद्ध घटादेर आकारम आपद्य सम्मिश्रतया भासमानो अपि वस्तुतः घटादेर विलक्षण स्वभाव एव तथा ज्ञान स्वरूप आत्मा बुद्धिवृत्त्या संबद्ध तदाकारम आपद्य अव्युक्ततया भासमानो अपि परमार्थतया बुद्धिवृत्तेः विलक्षणः नित्य शुद्ध असंग चिन्मात्र रूपः. So this is extended with another example of the lamp. The light of the lamp reflects off many padarthas. It takes the akara and reflects, but still it is different from the vishayas. Apanchikruta bhuta samashti sattva gunamsha karya bhutasya antakkaranasya nischay rupa kriyaya buddhiriti sankalpa vikalpa rupa kriyaya mana iti cha vyapadesha. We know this, how the same apanchikruta, the subtle elements come together to form antakkarana, which itself appears as buddhi or manah. Tasmad buddhi antakkaranad avyatirikta. Buddhi is not separate from antakkarana, the same antakkarana which is put together by mixing the subtle elements. That antakkarana cannot be atma, even if it is functioning as a buddhi. Tatascha ततश्च भौतिकांतकरण अव्यतिरिक्त बुद्धेरपि भौतिकत्वात् देह देहेन्द्रिय मनोवत् अनात्मत्वम् एव सिद्धम्. सो द आर्ग्युमेंट इज दैट इफ यू से दैट भौतिकत्वात् इंद्रियम न आत्मा मनस न आत्मा सो मनः न आत्मा ऑल दिस स्टेटमेंट्स इफ यू एग्री विथ which is what you have agreed with so far. You have not gone back and refuted all of them. You have built over the others' refutations. So you agree with their refutations. If you agree with their refutations as the bhuta karya cannot be atma, then how can you say that vijnana is atma, buddhi is atma? Because buddhi is just the role of the same antakkarana, which is put together. It is also bhuta karya. So bhuta karyatvat, meaning bhautikatvat, dehendriya manovat, just like deha indriya mana also, buddhi is also bhautika, is bhautika, is bhuta karya, therefore na atma. Kato Upanishad Tritiya Valyam Atmanaha Rata Swamitvena Buddhehe Sarathitvena Cha Varnanam Drishyate. Now this is for others who are listening to this, as in not for Bauddhas. Bauddhas don't care what Katopanishad says. They do not follow Vedas. So this is for the Siddhantis to understand Katopanishad Tritiya Valyam. In the third valley of Katopanishad, Atma. So there is a Rataswami Atma. We know this. It is there in Gita also, borrowed from Katopanishad. So there is a simile of the Ratha given and its components, with starting with the Vishayas and then the horses, the reins, all this. So Rathaswami is Atma, whereas Buddhi is Sarathi. Buddhi Sarathi Asya. So Buddhi is Sarathi, meaning not the Rathaswami, but the Sarathi. Rathaswami and Sarathi are different. Yatha Sarathi Vilakshana Rathaswami Tatha Buddhi Vilakshana Atma Bhavati. So Katopanishad refutes it. So do not take the Bauddha Paksha, because Katopanishad refutes it. It is Shruti Viruddha. So this is the refutation in the fourth point. Mama Buddhir Idanim Manda Idanim Tikshna Iti Mamata Vishyatvad Buddhehe Ahanta Vishyatvam Nayujyate Ataha Na Buddhir Atma. And what was explained earlier also, Mamata Vishya means Sambandha Shashti. Subject-object division is there, therefore buddhi is not atma. Atmanaha kshanikattvam vijnanavadi sammatam atyantam asangatam. this completely out of order. Vijnanavada people argue, even Dvaitins and some foolish Advaitins say that this Advaita of the Tikakaras sounds like Kshanika Vijnana. So they are mistaken. Why? Because Kshanikatvam, this is not there in any Advaita Siddhanta. Any Prakriya, no Prakriya talks about Kshanikatvam of Vijnana. Vijnana, consciousness. Atmanaha Kshanikatvam Vijnana Vadi Sammatam Atyantam Asangatam. What is Atyanta Asangata cannot be same as Vedanta. So the Westerners or Dvaitins, Vishishta Dvaitins, or anybody, logicians, whoever they are, or within Advaita, those who are trying to break up and say that, break up the Sampradaya itself, they say this orthodoxy is invalid. Or those who followed Bhagavan Shankaracharya, everyone else is invalid. All these people have a different opinion. All that is invalid because no Prakriya in Advaita says that Chaitanya is Kshanika. So they neither understand Buddhism nor do they understand the Tikakara's Mata there. Or not necessarily Tikakara, anybody else who has come up after Bhagavan Shankaracharya has brought out a Prakriya which is there in the Upanishad. Only 10 Upanishads are not the end of everything. 10 Upanishads are considered main because the Muktika Upanishad says that these are primary. So those who think that only 10 Upanishads are valid, they do not know Muktika Upanishad also. They know it because, Shankaracharya wrote Bhashya on this. This is the end of it. It is not the end of it. If you study it 100 times also, and if you still didn't get moksha, then you study it another 1000 times also, you will not get moksha. This is what the Muktika Vachan is. Muktika Upanishad says that if you do not get moksha on Mandukya Upanishad study, then you study these other Upanishads. There is a listing and there is a Krama also, not any order. People pick up the Upanishad in any order and study it and think that it is possible. It is possible with Tattva Bodha also. So that way Krama is not important. But if one thinks that I have not got mukti even now, I am not free, I am bound, then we should take the Krama as discussed in the Upanishad. One can pick one's own Shakha Upanishad first. That may work wonders. That is the reason one is born in a particular Shakha, in a particular Kutumba. So one's own Swashakha is most important. But even then, when one has to study outside the Shakha also, then Mandukya, if it hasn't worked, then there is a Krama to the Upanishad. Ishakena Kata Prashna Munda Mandukya Tittiri. Then Aitarescha Chandogya Brahad Tatha. So there is a sequence. This is the sequence in which Bhagavan Bhashyakara also wrote Bhashya. So comparing something else which is, different from what you know, without knowing either and saying that they are same is very petty thinking or with a different agenda. It is foolish. So we should not think that these are the 10 Upanishads only. There are so many Upanishads which have got lost in invasions and things like that. And in Kali Yuga Krama. But still, there are 108 Upanishads which are validated by Muktika Upanishad. And there is a Krama outside this. Without knowing them, we cannot make a statement, this is not Upanishadic or, this is not valid. All those Prakriyas do exist in the Upanishad, including the Yogika Prakriya. So all these are to be used by the sadhakas who cannot get this jnana. One vada or the other will click. Finally, our goal is Advaita Moksha. So whichever sadhana works, we should use that, whichever prakriya works, but we should not think that this atyanta asangata mata is advaita mata. It isn't. Tathatve uttamaranaha gata vatsare dattam dhanamasmin vatsare adharmana na adatum ichchet. Prathama kshane bhuktavan purusha uttara kshane truptoham asmiti na bruyat. So here it is said that if you do not have a continuing thing, that is what I said here, Chanika cannot be right, because somebody who has, you know, Tathatve, meaning if it is Kshanika is valid, then you cannot have somebody who has given a loan and somebody who is taking the loan, where there is no continuity there. That dhana which is given earlier, asmin vatsare, so it's going across the page, is a little difficult. So gatavatsare dattam dhanam asmin vatsare adhamaranat na adatum ichhet. One who has given dhana in the earlier samvatsara, earlier year, now this loan shark has to take it back, money. How will he remember? There has to be something continuing, right? You cannot have Kshanika Vijnana as to earlier year. So an example is given. Between two moments, if you cannot see that there cannot be continuity, take last year and this year. Last year, some money has been given to someone. Now you have to collect it. Who has given, who is going to collect? Where is the continuity at all? There is no anuvritti of anyone. If Atma is Kshanika, that Atma that lent the money in the last year and the Atma who is receiving now are different. There cannot be any connection at all. So some ridiculing example has been given there. Prathamakshane bhuktavan purusha uttarakshane truptom asmiti na bruyat. The same continuing person who is hungry earlier and now fed is satisfied, that it will not be possible. Atmana kshanikatve gatavatsare dhanam dattavata uttavarnasya purva kshane bhuktavata purushasya chet idanim abhava. Because that Atma which was there in the earlier year and now aren't there, and one who ate and one who is satisfied are different, that cannot be possible. Tasmad Atma nakshanikah. Atma nakshanikatve moksha sadhana kalapo vyarthasyat. If Atma is kshanika, then who is the sadhaka? Who else is getting mukti? It's all useless. Some ridiculous thinking. So all this is completely bogus. This is what is said here. We'll look at more in the next part. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namrut adhishthanam buddhyabodhyam buddher drukyatva nirvana param sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak param tadeva annamatvanyat iti me nischitamatihi tat sat.